So yes, let us discuss test also. So which is the only fundamental quantity out of the following? What was the answer to this question? Fundamental quantity out of pressure, force, etc. These things were given. What was the answer? Yes. Yes, Pritiksha. What was the answer?
Mass.
Yes, that was mass again.
Mass.
Yes. And in this picture where the vegetable seller was shown, he is measuring which physical quantity? Again, mass he is measuring. Okay. Then there was a question. How greater is centimeter? How greater is kilometer than a centimeter? Let us solve this. Okay.
So first of all, 1 centimeter is 10^-2 meter, and 1 kilometer is 10^3 meter. We want to compare them. Whenever we want to compare,
we have to divide. Whenever we want to compare the quantity, we divide them. So we divide kilometer by centimeter. 10^3 over 10^2. That is 10^3 + 2. Answer should be 10^5. But in the option, the options were given 10, 1 over 10, 10^3 or 10^5. 10^6. So which one is closest? That is 10^5. So answer was 10^6 there. Actual answer was 10^5. But out of the options given 10, 1 by 10, 10^3 and 10^6, which was the closest one? That was 10^5. So now next topic, let us cover the next topic now. Distance and displacement. So we have defined scalar and vector quantities. Now, first pair of comparison, we are taking distance and displacement. So let us see what is distance, what is displacement. Distance. Okay, suppose there is a person, okay, he is a stranger. He comes from some other city and he books a cab and then he wants to go to a hotel. Okay, the cabman, he takes him along a circular path. Okay, whereas the straight line distance between hotel and that bus stand is something else. Yes? Jia? Yes, any problem?
Ma'am, we haven't done scalar.
You haven't done? So why students were raising hand and Jatin told me the definition? Scalar quantity and vector quantity. Scalar quantities are those quantities that have magnitude. Magnitude matlab unki sirf value hoti hai. For example, we say mass is 10 kg. So 10 kg is the value, but direction is not needed. In such a case, direction is not needed. So such quantities are called scalar quantities. I give you one example. Okay, I give you one example. Suppose aap vegetable seller ke paas jaate ho. Theek hai, aap usko kehte ho ki I want 2 kg vegetables. Theek hai, to wo kya kehta hai ki east mein iska mass 2 kg hai, west mein iska mass 1.5 kg hai, north mein 1 kg hai. Aise to nahi kehta na wo. उसको उसके लिए डायरेक्शन की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है, वो बस आपको मेजर करके दे देता है, पैन के ऊपर बैलेंस करके मेजर करके आपको दे देता है. आप अपने क्लासमेट से टाइम पूछते हो कि कितने टाइम के बाद पीरियड ओवर होगा, सो यू डोंट मेंशन द टाइम कि इन दिस डायरेक्शन 10 मिनट्स है, इन दैट डायरेक्शन 15 मिनट्स है. यू डोंट से लाइक दिस एवर, राइट? सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन से that time is also a scalar quantity. So jisme hame sirf value ki zarurat chahiye, magnitude chahiye, direction nahi chahiye, those quantities are called scalar quantity. Right? Likhe definition. Scalar quantity, the physical quantity the physical quantities that need या that have the physical quantities that have only magnitude spelling देख लीजिए not the direction these are the physical quantities that have only magnitude not the direction they are called scalar quantities the physical quantities that have only magnitude not direction they are called scalar quantities so example likh lijiye as I told you mass time and length also distance also mass time distance these are scalar quantities in addition to that we have energy we have area volume work speed density these are also scalar quantities ये भी स्केलर क्वांटिटीज है ठीक है यस भवान सो राइट द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ स्केलर क्वांटिटीज हियर
मैम प्लीज कैन यू रिपीट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्केलर क्वांटिटीज
यस राइट डाउन द स्केलर क्वांटिटीज आर द क्वांटिटीज दीज आर द फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज दैट हैव ओनली मैग्नीट्यूड दे हैव ओनली मैग्नीट्यूड नॉट डायरेक्शन दे हैव ओनली मैग्नीट्यूड नॉट direction and these are the examples then on the other hand we have vector quantities these are the physical quantities vector quantities are the physical quantities these are the physical quantities that have magnitude as well as direction these are the physical quantities that have magnitude and direction both vector quantities are those physical quantities that have magnitude also and direction also example ab main aapko ek aur example deti hu suppose I throw a chalk where will it go in the downward direction or will it go in the upward direction it will go in the downward direction because earth is exerting a force on this chalk and we should see the direction of force that the earth exerts on any object so koi bhi cheez hum freely agar drop karte hain to automatically it goes downwards because the direction of earth force that is always downward so force is a vector quantity in which we want to know the direction तो ये बिना डायरेक्शन हमारा इसमें काम नहीं चलेगा हमें ये रीजन ही क्लियर नहीं होगा कि चौक डाउनवर्ड्स क्यों गिर रहा है क्योंकि उस फोर्स की डायरेक्शन डाउनवर्ड्स है ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एक्ट कर रहा है विच इज एक्टिंग ऑलवेज इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन सो फोर्स इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी दिस वे वी हैव मोर वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज ऑल्सो सो दैट विल बी क्लियर एज वी विल बी डिफाइनिंग देम एंड एक्सप्लेनिंग देम ठीक है तो एग्जाम्पल लिख लीजिए वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज के There are so many examples of vector quantities. Force is there, displacement is there. Force, displacement, velocity, acceleration. Force, displacement, velocity, acceleration, momentum. Okay, so many examples are there. These are all vector quantities. Okay, these are all vector quantities. ठीक है तो after this we are defining distance now. So let us come to distance now. So I was giving you example of a cabman. He वो उसको circular path के घुमा के लेके आता है to earn more money. Whereas the actual distance between that hotel and bus stand was a straight line distance, ठीक है? तो distance क्या होगा? Length of actual path covered by an object. Actually वो एक circular path से move करके वहां पे पहुंचा है तो that is the distance covered. और डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस बिटवीन इनिशियल एंड फाइनल पोजीशन. तो जो स्ट्रेट लाइन डिस्टेंस था होटल एंड बस स्टैंड में, वो डिस्प्लेसमेंट होगी. ठीक है, तो लिखिए डिस्टेंस की डेफिनेशन. द लेंथ ऑफ एक्चुअल पाथ, PATH पाथ. डिस्टेंस इज द लेंथ ऑफ एक्चुअल पाथ कवर्ड बाय एन ऑब्जेक्ट. डिस्टेंस इज डिफाइंड एज द लेंथ ऑफ एक्चुअल पाथ कवर्ड बाय एन ऑब्जेक्ट. इट इज द लेंथ ऑफ एक्चुअल पाथ कवर्ड बाय एन ऑब्जेक्ट. लेंथ ऑफ एक्चुअल पाथ कवर्ड बाय एन ऑब्जेक्ट, दैट इज कॉल्ड डिस्टेंस. ठीक है, डेफिनेशन हो गई. अब हम इसका एक एग्जाम्पल लिखते. राइट डाउन वन वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल. Write down, a man starts from point A. A man starts from point A and covers 4 kilometers due east matlab due east matlab east direction. You know the directions, east, west, north, south. तो वो ईस्ट की तरफ 4 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल करता है एंड रीचेस अ पॉइंट बी. अ मैन ट्रेवल 4 किलोमीटर ड्यू ईस्ट एंड रीचेस पॉइंट बी. देन ही कवर्स 3 किलोमीटर ड्यू नॉर्थ. अब 3 किलोमीटर वो नॉर्थ में कवर करता है एंड रीचेस पॉइंट सी. देन ही गोज 3 kilometers due north and reaches point C. What is the distance covered by him? Question is, what is the distance covered by him? So actually, वो कहाँ कहाँ गया? पहले यहाँ से यहाँ गया, फिर यहाँ से यहाँ गया. तो इस path की length को हम बोलेंगे distance. So in this case, distance is AB plus BC. In this case, distance is AB plus BC. 4 plus 3, 7 kilometers. In this case, distance covered is 4 plus 3, 7 kilometers. ठीक है, that is 4 plus 3, 7 kilometers. In this case, the distance covered is 4 plus 3, 7 kilometers. ठीक है, and obviously हमें इसके लिए कोई direction की जरूरत नहीं पड़ी answer लिखने में. So distance is a scalar quantity. Distance is a scalar quantity. Next point related to distance is, distance is, its unit is, standard unit is meter. अभी हमने किलोमीटर में दिया है, ठीक है, हम लेंथ को मीटर में भी एक्सप्रेस करते हैं, बट स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट ऑफ लेंथ यू हैव रेड अर्लियर, वो मीटर ही है. सो डिस्टेंस इज ऑल्सो फॉर्म ऑफ लेंथ, इट्स एसआई यूनिट इज ऑल्सो मीटर. राइट, एंड डिस्टेंस कैन नेवर बी नेगेटिव. डिस्टेंस जीरो भी नहीं हो सकता, नेगेटिव भी नहीं हो सकता. यू विल नेवर हियर ऑफ एनी इंस्टेंस वेयर डिस्टेंस इज नेगेटिव. ठीक है, सो दिस इज अबाउट डिस्टेंस. एंड वी हैव अ डिवाइस कॉल्ड ऑडोमीटर दैट इज फिटेड इन आवर व्हीकल्स एंड दैट गिव्स अस टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय अस. आप जो भी व्हीकल ड्राइव कर रहे हो, कार ड्राइव कर रहे हो, बाइक ड्राइव कर रहे हो, उसमें आगे जो है डैशबोर्ड पे 2 स्केल्स लगे होते हैं. एक जो होता है ऑडोमीटर होता है जो आपको डिस्टेंस देता है, दूसरा स्पीडोमीटर होता है, वो हम बाद में डिस्कस करते हैं क्या देता है. तो लिख लीजिए, व्हाट इज एन ऑडोमीटर. व्हाट इज एन ऑडोमीटर. ऑडोमीटर इज अ डिवाइस दैट टेल्स अस the total distance traveled by the vehicle. Odometer is a device that gives us total distance traveled by a vehicle. So, ek vehicle mein kitna distance ab tak travel kiya hai, wo add hota jayega, cumulative hota hai. Agar aap reset karte ho to 0-0 pe aa jata hai dobara se, to aapki ek particular journey ka distance nikal aata hai wahan se. but otherwise it will go on giving you total distance travel. ठीक है. So this is about distance. Now next term is displacement. Let us define displacement now. Let us define displacement now. How do we define this? It is the shortest distance traveled by an object between initial and final position. Likhe definition pehle, then I tell you its meaning. It is the shortest distance traveled. It is the shortest distance traveled by an object between. It is the shortest distance traveled by an object between initial and final position. It is the shortest distance traveled by an object between initial and final position. Initial and final position. ठीक है. अब यही वाला एग्जांपल ले लेते हैं. शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस आपको मैथ्स में पता है कि क्या होता है. यू हैव टू पॉइंट्स. हाउ कैन यू ड्रॉ शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस बिटवीन देम. The straight line between those two points is the shortest distance possible. I think math में ये आपने पढ़ा होगा. ठीक है. So in whatever situation is given to us, we will see which is the starting point, which is the finishing point. जैसे कि यहाँ पे उसका starting point A था और उसका final point C था. बस हमने वो दो points ढूंढ लेने हैं, उनको join कर देना है. That straight line will give us displacement. So in this case, AC is the displacement. आपने उन दोनों को join कर देना है. Actual length of path नहीं देखनी. जिस मर्जी path से आया हो, आप ये देखोगे कि कहाँ से motion start हुई थी, where it ended, and just by drawing a straight line between initial and final position, you can find the displacement. And it's a vector quantity. Its direction will be from starting point to final point. So this is the direction. We indicate by putting a vector here. So our displacement in this particular example is AC. Our displacement is AC. Now how to solve that? That will depend upon the situation. Like in this case, this displacement can be found by finding hypotenuse of this right angle triangle using Pythagoras theorem. So let us apply Pythagoras theorem and find this hypotenuse in this case. So that will be under the root AB square plus BC square. AB is 4 and BC is 3. Okay, let us solve this. 4 square is 16, 3 square is 9. That is root 25. The answer is 5 kilometers. So you have seen that in this particular example, distance was 7 kilometers, but displacement was 5 kilometers. And there is a direction also associated with it. It is in this direction. Okay? It is in this direction, northeast direction. Right? So you can write 5 centimeters due northeast. So for mentioning displacement, we have to see the direction. So we conclude that displacement is a vector quantity. Displacement is a vector quantity. But since again it is a form of length, its SI unit is also meter. Its SI unit is also meter. And one thing more you notice here, that distance is greater than displacement here. Notice that distance is greater than displacement here. All right. Can anybody tell me now, can ever distance and displacement be equal? Kabhi aise ho sakta hai, like here, distance is greater than displacement. Is it possible that distance and displacement are equal also? Is it possible? Yes, students, anyone, you think about it and tell me. Is it possible that distance and displacement are equal? Yes, Jatin, turn your video on.
Ma'am, no,
then
mam no displacement mam displacement will be zero and distance will not be equal to zero.
No beta, we are not asking whether they can be zero or not. I'm just asking that can distance and displacement be ever equal? Yes, Aryan.
From A to B only.
Yes.
Ma'am, when we have to go from A to B only?
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, distance and displacement can be equal. Okay, if the object is already moving along straight line path, पहले से ही object straight line path के along आ रही है, तो actual length of path भी straight है और displacement तो वैसे ही straight होती है. So yes, distance and displacement can be same if already the object is moving along a straight line path. So add this question also. Write down. Can distance and displacement covered by an object ever be the same? Can distance and displacement covered by an object ever be the same? Let's do a numerical on this basis. Small question on this basis. Write down, three girls are skating on a circular ice track. Three girls A, B, C are skating on a circular ice track. They are going from A point to B point. They are skating along the diameter of the skating track. A girl is going like this, B girl is going like this, and C girl is going like this. Yeah, points ko change kar lo. Suppose this is Q point, this is P point, and three girls A, B, C, they are going from P to Q point along three different paths. Okay, write the statement once again. Three girls A, B, C are skating along a circular ice track. Skating along a circular ice track. Okay. They are going along different paths from P point to Q point. They are going along different paths from P to Q point. For which girl distance is equal to displacement? For which girl distance is equal to displacement? Yes. Who will tell me? For which girl distance is equal to displacement? Yes. Any idea? Yes, Dia.
Ma'am, B.
Yes, B girl. Because why, Raghav? Will you tell me the reason? Raghav Kumar?
Ma'am, because it is the shortest distance traveled by the B girl. Yes,
because B girl is already traveling along the straight line path. So this is the distance traveled by her also and displacement also. Because we will see final point and initial point and we will draw straight line. This is going to be displacement. For these two girls also, this is the displacement. But for B girl, this is also equal to distance. Okay? So yes, for B girl, and you will give the reason also, because she is already traveling along a straight line. So in her case, distance is equal to displacement. All right. Okay? Okay, next, one more question you write down as homework. And you will try it. I'll be asking tomorrow what is the answer to this question. Write down. Write down. A cyclist. A cyclist starts from center O of a circular path. A cyclist starts from center O of a circular path of radius 1 kilometer. एक साइक्लिस्ट यहां से स्टार्ट करता है जर्नी. ही गोज टू द बाउंड्री, देन ही गोज टू क्यू पॉइंट, देन ही कम्स बैक टू ओ पॉइंट. सो अ साइक्लिस्ट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम पॉइंट ओ, द सेंटर ऑफ अ सर्कुलर पार्क ऑफ रेडियस 1 किलोमीटर, कॉमा रीचिंग पॉइंट पी, देन क्यू, एंड देन रिटर्न्स बैक टू ओ. P, Q and returns back to O. What is the distance and displacement covered by him? What is the displacement and distance covered by him? So you will think about it and we'll be discussing tomorrow. And now let us write the differences between distance and displacement on the basis of what we discussed today. Okay, let us write differences between distance and displacement. First, difference is of definition. We just defined, you can write the definition. Distance is the length of actual path covered by an object. Displacement is shortest distance traveled between initial and final position. Okay, you will write this. Second point, you will write it's a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. You will write distance is a scalar quantity, displacement is a vector quantity. Third thing you will write, distance can never be negative. Displacement can be positive, negative or zero also. Displacement, I'll explain this point tomorrow, how displacement can be negative also. So distance can never be negative. Any other point of difference? As we have seen, distance can never be less than displacement. Distance can never be less than displacement. And displacement can never be more than displacement. They can be equal. But you won't see any situation where distance is less than displacement. जैसे हमने अभी एक numerical किया था, distance 7 kilometer था, displacement 5 kilometer. So on the basis of that, we can conclude कि वो उससे कम नहीं हो सकता कभी भी और वो उससे ज्यादा नहीं. ठीक है. So you think about any more point and if any more point comes to your mind, we can discuss tomorrow.